What is good, Mexit Planners? Are you a digital nomad that works remotely and would like to do so from any place in the world? Or are you an expat that lives abroad but needs to pay bills back in your home country? Or would you simply just like to watch the Super Bowl or any English-speaking USA TV series on any streaming platform of your choice? If the answer to any of those questions is yes, then you're gonna wanna stick around and watch this video where I break down virtual private networks or VPN technology for you right now. I'm gonna explain the technology, I'm gonna tell you the difference between a hardware and a software VPN, and I'm gonna explain the three different use cases why you would wanna use a VPN. Also, be sure to stay to the end because I'm gonna tell you some very valuable information that I learned over the course of a 20-year career in data security. Let's get it. VPN technology stands for virtual private networks. To explain a little further, VPN technology allows for a device on one end, the client, to set up a virtual tunnel to a device located in another physical location, say the United States. That device on the other end in the other physical location is called the VPN server. The data that is transmitted between the VPN client and the VPN server is encrypted. Therefore, no one can see inside of that private network or VPN connection. The VPN tunnel allows for the VPN client to appear to be on the same physical network as the VPN server, which could literally be anywhere in the world. For my Trekkies out there, this is the closest thing that we have in 2022 to the teleporter on the Star Trek Enterprise. If you're a Trekkie, leave me comments below and let me know. VPN technology exists in two form factors, VPN software and VPN hardware devices. VPN software devices allow you to install them on any device, be it an iPhone, an Android phone, an Android TV, Amazon Fire Stick, computers, and routers. This flexibility allows a user to connect and encrypt the traffic on a device-by-device basis. Hardware VPNs typically run the open VPN communication protocol, and they allow for the router to act as a client side of the VPN connection. Also, hardware VPNs allow for clients to remotely connect to your home network as a VPN server. So hardware VPNs can act as both the client and the server. If you're a digital nomad or an expat, you want to make sure that your router supports client-side VPN connections. A hardware VPN allows for every device that is behind the connected device to be hidden behind the VPN tunnel. So if this is my router and it is connected to the VPN tunnel, all of the devices, my computer, my iPhone, anything that's connected, hanging off Wi-Fi that is behind this router is connected to over the VPN tunnel. A hardware VPN is a great solution for a digital nomad that needs to work remotely or an expat that needs to have all of their devices in the house connected to the VPN. Most routers will support VPN connections and allow for clients to connect to the router, but only certain routers will act as a VPN client. So what can you do with the VPN? Once you have a secure VPN connection, you're able to watch shows that are only available in certain regions on certain streaming platforms. Some streaming platforms will only work with the VPN server because they're not available outside of, say, the United States or Canada. The others have availability but offer a very different regional catalog based on the location of the country that you're connecting from. Another way I use VPN technology was to pay for my electric bills and water bills to my local EMC and water provider back in Georgia that blocked access to their services from computers outside the United States. Because these bills, the utilities, as well as the local water authority in my county only had customers that were local, they had policies on their firewalls that would block access to them, to their servers from outside of the country. And that is a very typical policy on firewalls in state and local governments because they only provide access to a particular client in their region or county. Therefore, there is no need for a computer from, say, Russia or China to connect the local servers unless, you know, that's a high probability of those computers potentially doing something malicious on that network. This is also a common policy in local school districts because most students will be geographically located Even if they're working remote or hybrid, they'll be geographically located in a close area to the school district. Even with remote learning, if you're connecting to a local school district, say Fulton County, Gwinnett County, Cobb County, or any of those places in, say, Atlanta, Georgia, they're expecting their students to be geographically located or at least to live geographically in those districts. And so if you go to a remote country and try to connect back, you're probably going to have a problem because their firewalls are going to block that type of connection. The final use case is for my digital nomads that work remotely. A VPN will hide your location by hiding the true IP address of the client device. Your IP address or internet protocol address is like your physical home address that you're given by your ISP. So your router in your house connects to an internet service provider, say Telmex or Total Play or Izzi here in Mexico. That ISP gives the router an IP address, and that is your public facing internet address. A VPN server or a client connecting over VPN will hide your true IP address and allow the remote computer to connect to websites and potentially corporate internet pages from abroad. However, I must caution you, please listen to this point. I spent over 20 years in the data security space. You should be aware that deep packet technology exists today in almost all current generations of firewalls. What deep packet inspection is the ability to look at the protocols that are transversing across the wire. Now, they can't see inside of the encrypted tunnel, but what they can see is all of the setup and communication between the server and the rest of the world. So I'll give you a good example. If a streaming platform sees that every person connecting from that streaming or connecting to that streaming platform server is coming from one IP address, the IP address of the VPN server, they can quickly block that and know that that is probably from a VPN server. So if 25 or 2500 different accounts have the same IP address, there's a good chance that they're being aggregated and then transversing over a VPN server to connect to that streaming platform. So what they will do is simply block the range of IP addresses or those IP addresses on the VPN server. That's why it's really important to pick the right VPN software. Some VPN service providers like NordVPN also provide for obfuscated servers that are specialized in hiding the traffic, the VPN traffic. I use Nord on everything, on my phone, on my iPad, on my Amazon Fire Stick, across the board. And if you want to use Nord, please do me a favor and click the affiliate link below. They're not paying me for this video, but I truly believe in their technology. My recommendation to you, if you work for a Fortune 500 company or a large government agency with letters, do not try to fool them by using VPN technology. Get approval to work abroad or to work remotely and to use that computer remotely, because that could be a potential problem. They can detect VPN technology. If you got 1 ounce of information out of this video that you like, do me a favor and bang that like button. Leave me comments below. If you want to know how to get the best internet here in Mexico, check out this video over here. Until next time, MexitPlans Monty, I'm out.